Everybody was nice, the party was pumping.
V-I-O.
And everybody having a ball.
V-I-O.
Until the fellas start the name calling.
V-I-O.
And the girls respond to the call. I have a pool and shout out.
Who let the dogs out? Who let the dogs out? Who let the dogs out? Who let the dogs out?
I see the young people had a ball, cause Billy Bonders get out. Get back, Gruffy, bash Gruffy. Get back, you flea infest in mongrel.
Who let the dogs out?
Say, my doggy is nothing if he don't have.
Welcome back, Park City. I'm Melanie Edwards here with Denise and the Save a Dog and Kids program. Welcome, Denise. Glad you could come.
It's good to see you.
Yes,
again.
Good to see you. We've had you on a few times, haven't we?
It's been really fun. And I want to thank you also, because I don't know if everybody knows in Park City, that your son Cameron was able to foster a puppy for us, which now has the most wonderful home in Colorado.
Well, I can attest to the fact that it's a good program because we did take a puppy on for 2 months,
yes.
I guess. Cutest yes. little thing I've ever, I mean, this little hound. And we didn't teach the little coon hound how to howl, so last time we knew she wasn't howling.
That's a good thing. Tell us generally, good matters.
Thank you. Tell us about the Save a Dog and Kids program, how it started basically and what it's about.
Okay. And we have classes in three counties now, Utah County, Salt Lake County, and up here in Park City, where the kids come once a week with our trainers and they learn how to train the dogs to be well-mannered, but then they have a really good time because they learned to teach them to do fun tricks.
Right.
The kids come up with their own ideas, whether it's skateboarding or jumping through a hoop. And today we're going to have one of our kids here in Park City because we went to TMS here in Park City and we did a little assembly and all these kids came running to us and asked us, could we please foster a puppy?
What great support you have. You have so much support going on with this. I think there's a lot of people who agree that what you're doing is a wonderful thing.
And I'm thankful for that.
Yeah, that's great. So
you've
what
got
else?
To know them with hard work, you can accomplish any dream. And that's what we're trying to bring to the kids of Utah.
That's right.
Is this kind of rewarding experience that you can work hard and you can accomplish these wonderful dreams and you can show everyone else and they can applaud what you've done.
It's interesting that you say that it's a rescue. You're rescuing the dogs, but also you're really helping out the kids as well.
That's
working
what I'm
with
today, I want to introduce you to Raquel. She is one of the TMS students that's joined our kids club up here in Park City. She just won a wonderful award. She's top in her class because she got the highest achievement award in our kids club working with Baby Gorf for 6 months. First, kind of introduce you to some of the things that we work with. Some of the basic things are sits and fun things like shake and down. And I'm going to have Raquel demonstrate what she's gotten Baby Gore to learn to do. Jump, beautiful, good job, give her a hand. All right, good job, sweetheart, I'm so proud.
Them helps the kids bound with the dogs and helps them learn really fast. We work to each special need of every dog, and we have a lot of fun trying to work with these dogs and helps for the people that come to adopt them, because that way they get to adopt a well-trained dog.
So, tell us about your involvement in the program, Nancy, and what it's done for you.
I am a teen foster home, and I love taking care of dogs. It's introduced me to a whole new world, and it makes me feel needed. I like being a mom.
And how many dogs have you trained?
I've trained 14 at my house, and I've really enjoyed every one of them.
Is it kind of hard to give them up, though?
You know what? One dog is not worth letting all the others die in the shelter.
And Nancy, you certainly have the vision of the program.
Adam Webb is the foster parent for an animal rescued from the shelter over the holidays. He will take care of this dog until an adoptive home can be found. It's one of 13 animals that showed off their new tricks that they've learned in recent weeks since being saved. The Save a Dog and Kids program works to rescue unwanted animals from shelters and teach them new tricks so that they are more likely to be adopted.
Big news this afternoon, the Delta Center has gone to the dogs.
To the real four-legged...
You adopt a dog or a puppy like Max here, the stars recommend you stay in your seats for the halftime show because there will be a special program of young people who have learned to train their pets.
And in our classes, they learn how to train a dog, how to socialize the dog, because if they're not socialized when they're very young, you have behavior problems when they're older, they're aggressive, they're not friendly with people and other dogs. So we socialize them and then we train them.
Things to do this weekend, and I know this is something that Reagan will mark down on her calendar.
I know,
because
I will.
You love pets. Oh, if you guys want to help homeless pets this weekend, there's a great thing you can do to get a picture with your pet. Denise, come up here.
Oh,
Denise DeVink from Save a Dog and Kids is here. And
D.B. Cooper, right?
This is D.B. Cooper.
Oh, he's
he was
so
rescued
cute.
Last Christmas. His family threw him away as a puppy because he's a Jack Russell Terrier mix and he was too hyper. Well, this little performer has been performing for the Utah Stars at the Delta Center, the Park City 4th of July Parade, the Utah State Fair as well, with his little kids.
Did he sit? Oh, he hates that hat. Did he sit? Okay, stay. D.B. up. Over. Down.
Oh.
Good boy. D.B. up. Over.
Good boy, D.B.
Oh, good job, D.B.
And puppies visit. Many children have to give up their pets when their families are hit hard. But today, four dogs and some eager volunteers showed up at the Jubilee Center downtown to spread some holiday cheer. The group known as Save a Dog and Kids, Inc. rescues abandoned dogs and brings them into children's lives to help them learn some of life's more important lessons.
It's fun.
So, we keep these dogs alive. We give them a good family environment and healthy. And while we get them fixed and everything and find them homes. And they are, all of them, wonderful family dogs. I haven't had a bad one yet. They're beautiful dogs that just deserve a chance to get a good home.
Save a Dog rescued some puppies this week and put them up for adoption. Tonight at 9, we'll have an update on whether they found new homes this holiday weekend.
Mm-hmm. West Jordan. Come see these beautiful dogs, you guys, and thank you so much for having us.
Thank you.
Okay?
That was the easiest interview I ever did, Sean.
Yeah, I just stood her looking cute. Now, these dogs are awesome. They're beautiful, absolutely beautiful.
They are.
So everyone should get out there. Everyone should get out there. Mm. If you need a pet, it's a great time of year to get one for the family.
Mm, for the
and
holidays.
These ones, most of them, I mean, so trained, so nice. We said sit, and every one of the dogs just sat right down. So
they're
beautiful dogs. We gave the number. We can give it again later in the show to let you know what's going on, and thank you so much for coming
thank
in.
You,